everyone, this is G. Kiran Kumar, Assistant Professor, AC Department from Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. Today we are going to discussing about Digital Communication Laboratory, in that pulse amplitude modulation. So how to change the amplitude of the pulse with respect to the input message signal? Let us see the circuit diagram of the pulse amplitude modulation and demodulation.
So it is similarly looks like sampling output. Okay, now let us see the what are the basic circuits and what are the basic connections in the pulse amplitude modulation circuit. Now here you can see, this is the pulse amplitude modulation circuit. In this we have to give RF output to the input to the pulse amplitude modulator, and one of the input, that is message signal input, that is AF from the function generator. So before giving to the input, that is AF, we have to calculate the output of the function generator. So here I am giving around 10 kilohertz frequency to the input of the message signal, frequency to pulse amplitude modulator kit. So I am just see the output values of the function generator here. So I am just checking the output levels. So see here, see the CRO output. So this is the input signal with 10 kilohertz, around 10 kilohertz frequency I am giving to the input of the pulse amplitude modulator. So after verifying that input signal, here the function generator output, that is the message signal, is given to the input of the pulse amplitude modulator. Okay, you can give the positive value here, that is the output of the function generator, and you can connect this ground to ground. And now let us see the clock frequency, that is nothing but RF signal. Here I am verifying the RF output here. This is the RF signal generated, nothing but carrier signal. So I am just cross verifying the output value of the RF signal generator. Here you need to shorten these two pins. Then let us see the output value. Here this is the clock signal. This is the clock signal or carrier frequency. So based upon the input message signal from the function generator, the amplitude of this clock can also be varied. So pulse amplitude modulation, amplitude of the pulse changes with respect to the message signal. Now let us see the output of the pulse amplitude modulator. Here this is the PAM circuit, pulse amplitude modulator circuit. I have already given that input, one of the input, that is message signal frequency here, and the second input is the RF signal. So multiplication of pulses and message signal, we will get the PAM input. Here RF input. So from this I am giving RF input and message signal input. These two inputs after giving, we have to shorten these pins, that is, so connection 1, and from this pin 2, we have to give the connection, one more connection. From this pin, we have to connect pin number 1. So after that, we have to see the output of the PAM signal. See, this is the output of the PAM signal, right? Now coming to here, see, so this is the PAM output signal, pulse amplitude modulation, amplitudes of the pulses changes with respect to message signal. Here the pulse amplitude is different, here the pulse amplitude is different, here the maximum pulse amplitude. Okay, so see, for the cross verification purpose, I am comparing with the input signal with the PAM output. So for that, I am considering channel 2 with the message signal. With message signal here to channel 1. One is the message signal and other one is series. So this is a comparison in between the both signals. So this is the output. See here, this is the PAM signal, pulse amplitude signal. This is the message signal. So based upon the amplitude values, see here, this is the positive value of the message input frequency. Okay, so this is the positive peak. For that positive peak, the amplitudes are positive levels, are the amplitudes are high. For this negative peak, the amplitude is low. So this is about the PAM signal. So for positive, we'll get the high amplitude. For negative, we'll get the low amplitude of the pulses. Pulse amplitude modulation. Amplitude of the pulses changes with respect to the message signal amplitude. So this is about the pulse amplitude modulation. Now let us go for the pulse amplitude demodulation process. Here you can see the pulse amplitude demodulator. So for this demodulator, we have to give the input, that is PAM input is given to here, and shorten these two pins from here to here and from here to here. So next you have to connect the probe to the demodulator output. Now let us see the connections. So this is the modulated output. This is the modulated output, and this modulated PAM output is given to the demodulator input, and I'm going to check the demodulation. So before going to demodulation, we have to shorten these two pins. So here to here. So afterwards, you have to calculate, you have to see the output from here. So now let us see. So here you can see the demodulated output from the PAM demodulator. So this is the PAM demodulation output, that is looks like input signal. But one more thing you have to identify, that some phase reversal can be appear here. So after comparison the input signal, see the phase reversal, 180 degrees phase shift can be occurred in between the input and demodulated output. Okay, but the frequency is same for the both signals.
This is about pulse amplitude modulation and demodulation. So you have to know that the amplitude of the pulse changes with respect to the amplitude of the message signal. If you change the amplitude of the message signal, the amplitude of the pulse also can be changes. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.